friend. We have to make a good impression on this guy.
Oh, don't worry. I'm sure he's a vegetarian. At least if he's not, he won't be a lot of time out there with him.
Oh, well, if he maybe he's a friend of God. If he is, then we'll be able to see each other on the weekends.
He probably knocks on Brian's door. Brian opens the door looking smooth and slightly disheveled. It is 6 o'clock in the morning. Brent is very cheery and a little obnoxious. Brian looks at Brent and then catches sight of the chicken in the bay. Brent immediately goes into his speech.
Well, good morning to you, sir. You probably wonder what I'm doing at your doorstep at 6 o'clock in the morning with this chicken here.
Well, it's a little early for breakfast, and I prefer cereal, really.
Well, sir, take a gander at this fine specimen of a chicken here.
I see a chicken, not a goose.
Oh, that's just a figure of speech. Take a gander. It's a figure of speech, sir.
No, I shouldn't have taken the second-hand pharmaceuticals.
just a figure of speech, sir. That's all.
Oh, well, speaking of figures, what exactly are you doing with this? Yeah.
Oh,
you mean, yeah, what do you make for?
Oh, well, I prefer making stick figures, sir.
What?
Yeah.
Are you telling me that you're going to people's houses at 6 in the morning selling a chicken for $1 million?
Oh, no, sir, no, sir. I thought you were talking about drawing, and I prefer making stick figures.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, I see.
So, let me get this. You have just one chicken, and you're going from door to door, waking people up, trying to sell them a chicken. You know, some people may not think it's a joke. I don't think it's a joke.
Well, sir, look, this is you never know what kind of good pets chickens will make. You know, I've enjoyed Greta's company for years and years. You know, and
Greta, yeah. You named the chicken and yourself. Why would you name the chicken if you're selling it?
Such is the life of a door-to-door chicken salesman, sir. But you take credit here. An excellent pet.
I don't know about that. I can't even believe I'm having this conversation. But, go ahead.
Well, you know, as long as I've had credit, she's been a wonderful pet. I've devoted hours and hours, you know. She's a really wonderful pet. Take a look at her, sir.
Oh, yes. And I suppose she's good company, too.
Oh, she's excellent company, sir. She'll keep you company all day long. She's wonderful for, you know, social events and such.
Well, let me tell you what. I have plenty of good company in my wife, who's not only a good listener to this, but happens to hate chicken. And I don't care for the humans herself.
You can hear that. You don't like chickens? Oh, but this is a beautiful chicken, you know, and they make excellent pets, you know, and just think about, you know, the novelty of having a chicken cluttering in your room at night. It will be a novelty that all your friends, relatives, enemies will be amazed by.
Well, I don't like chickens. It's that simple, and let me tell you why. I don't like the way they bob and breathe and go down. It looks like they're seasick.
Oh, well, sir, if chickens didn't bob their heads like this, then you would see them falling all over the place. They'd be tripping and falling over. Much easier to catch. They would have been extinct long ago. But, you know, chickens do that because they can't walk and focus at the same time. So if they can't see where they're going, they'll trip over. A chicken has to walk, stop, refocus its eyes, and keep going, which is why their heads bob back and forth.
Well, that's another thing I don't like about chickens. And I'll tell you what that is. Chickens peck each other all the time. You know how much money chicken farmers lose to chickens pecking each other all the time?
Well, sir, since the invention of contacts for
what?
Chickens...
You're not pulling the wool over my eyes. Are you trying to tell me that there are actually companies out there that lose hundreds and thousands of dollars every year to make thousands of limbs for hundreds of millions of chickens?
Well, it's a question of profit, sir. The lenses take a couple cents to make, and that's all. The chicken sees red, it'll peck at it, which is why farmers lose lots of money when chickens peck each other. Now, these lenses make it so that the chickens don't see red, and it saves the farmer thousands of dollars.
I think you're unhinged.
Oh,
be just fine, sir. By the way, you know you are ready to eat, right?
Is that a fact?
You don't eat chickens, do you?
Well,
Greta insists that you not eat chickens.
What? Are you trying to sell me a chicken that dictates what I am going to eat or am not going to eat? Let me tell you what, my wife has already assumed that role, and she's very good at it, and she's the most dependent to play second fiddle to a common variety of ordinary barnyard chicken.
You hurt her feelings. She's crying now.
She's not crying. She's clucking.
Oh, but sir, just think about, you know, the joy of having your own pet chicken. You know, I mean, just think about, you know, look at the gloss in her feathers. See how not a feather out of place, sir. You know, and she'll be, you know, think of years of feathered bliss.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. I don't know why I'm asking this, but how much do you want for that chicken?
Well, sir, it's not so much a question as my making money of it as providing a nice home for Greta. I used to be normal, I used to be normal, sir. Now life is so much better. You know, since I've had I take walks in the fence, in the park. I take walks in the park. I stop and smell the flowers. Since Greta's come into my life, I've been so much happier.
Well.
She provides lovely eggs. I like eggs, and good company, you'll get compliments from all of your friends, family, and relatives.
Well, we actually do like eggs. I do eat a fair number of them.
Don't listen to her, Greta. Let's take you inside. Welcome to your new home. Bye-bye.